in the same region,
and also similar to, although the sound is different, similar to cough. So yesterday we spent a few minutes talking about differences and similarities between our parents and ourselves. Differences and similarities. These are nouns, aren't they? Differences and similarities. What's the adjective that goes with differences? Do you remember? It's an easy one, it's a very common adjective.
Different.
Different. Different is the adjective.
Different.
And what's the adjective that goes with similarities?
Similar.
Yes, similar. Differences, similarities. And if someone said to you, okay, differences and similarities are nouns, what are differences? What are differences? What's another way to describe differences?
Not the same.
But it's a noun.
Okay.
It's a noun. I'll help you with a word. I'll give you an idea from a previous task that we did. Many ways to be smart. Many ways to be smart. So I'm going to give you the word ways. So how would you describe differences? Me and my father, we have differences. Someone asks you, what are differences? What does it mean? What does it mean?
Look like, but not the same.
So it's ways we are what?
Different.
Different. Yeah, ways we are different. So similarities are ways we are similar. Yeah. Ways we are similar. Differences are ways we are different. So similarities in ways that are similar. So yesterday we were thinking about ways we are different and similar, ways we are different, ways we are similar with our parents, and the types of differences were food was a type of difference. Drink was a type of difference. Do you remember any more?
Habits.
Very good. A very useful word. What are habits?
Can you give me an example of a habit? Give me an example of a habit.
Habit? Playing sport. Making.
Well, you see, that could be a hobby.
Coaching. Make something. Like a crochet or knitting.
That could be more like a hobby. What's a habit?
Something
bad
habit.
Okay,
yes, smoking. Exactly, yeah.
And smoking.
Smoking, yeah.
Drink.
Yeah.
And somebody cartoon.
Oh, okay, smoking, spitting, yeah. Yeah. It's not just bad things though. Habits can be good things. Your mother used to go to the market, but not just to buy things.
Yes. Shopping window.
Window shopping and talking to the neighbours.
Yeah.
Chatting to neighbours. It's not a hobby, is it? It's not a sport. It's a habit. Yeah, window shopping. So. Yeah. So habits, they're not all bad. They can be good things as well. Chatting to the neighbours. Feeding the birds.
Good manners. Good manners.
Good manners. Yeah.
Please.
Good manners. Sure.
Good manner and good manners. Is adjective or noun?
Good manners is a noun.
Noun and good manner.
Good mannered.
Good mannered.
Adjective.
Adjective.
Yeah, good mannered. Good mannered. Different hobbies, different habits. Any other differences that we mentioned yesterday? No one mentioned clothes. Are your clothes very different from your parents?
Yeah.
Yeah?
My parents, they always wear old fashioned.
Right, yeah. Mm-hmm. What's an example of old-fashioned clothes?
Old-fashioned? Very old-fashioned is light jonga bin.
Oh, the old-fashioned colours.
Colour and style.
Okay, yeah.
Old style.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What you wear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Traditional old-fashioned clothes. Yeah, and of course we talked about family size, didn't we? Often our parents came from bigger families. Not always. Sometimes it's the opposite. But in general, a difference between us and our parents can be family size. You have four brothers and sisters, is that right? Four. You have five in total.
That's five.
And your father, how many brothers and sisters did he have?
Just one child.
Really?
Yeah.
Your father was an only child?
One child.
And your mother?
Your mother, five.
Five, okay. Yeah.
Five.
Yeah. So you're the opposite. Your father came from a very small family.
The big. He came to China.
Yeah.
He was born in China.
Yeah.
He came to China.
Mm-hmm.
He's only one child.
Yeah. Just one child.
But his father is a big family.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so the family is big, but he was an only child. Yeah. So that's the difference between generations. So these are some examples of differences. Quite a lot of differences. Have a look at page 40, please. Page 40. Choose.
Okay,
thank you. You can see that there are five spaces, so you need to think
of
five differences. Me and my parents. If you don't have children, don't worry about it. You don't have to fill this one in. If you have children, if you prefer to write about differences between you and your children, if you prefer, do this one. If you prefer to write about you and your parents, do this one. Okay. Now pay attention that the format is subject verb. That's what they suggest. So it's me. I like salads and sandwiches. My parents. My parents like lamb and rice. So we don't put nouns. Don't put things like bigger house, smaller house. Yeah? Don't put nouns. We need verbs. So my parents have. My parents liked. My parents wore. My parents wore. My parents ate. My parents eat. Okay? Remember, you have the irregular verbs on page 154. If you need irregular verbs, eat, wear, think, speak. Do your parents speak in a different way? Yeah, so you have irregular verbs there to find the past tense. Does that make sense? So think of verbs, don't think of nouns. Everyone will have different answers because everyone has different parents and different children. Yeah. Okay. Any questions?
some dog and I want to take it to my home and feed them and take care of them. What do I say about them? I don't know how to say in English.
Well, you just said it.
Feed it.
Yeah, care for it.
Care for it. Care
you
for
want to care for dogs?
I like careful dog. Okay.
You want to care for dogs?
Yes. Because my family, they don't like dog.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You want to care for dogs?
Care for dog.
Okay, for dog.
Care for or careful?
Care
for or careful? Care for.
Only difference, only eating the food or difference?
Not just food, drink, clothes, hobbies,
okay.
Family size, anything, habits, preferences.
Thank you.